Welcome. Today, let's explore live looping. So if you're unfamiliar with the concept of live looping, it basically means that you stack up instruments one after the other until you have your complete song arrangement. And you're probably familiar with artists like Beardyman or Imogen Heap. Oh, and I highly recommend checking out an artist called Dub Effects, because he's just superb at emulating drums, basses, everything with his mouth, and he's also an excellent vocalist. So check out his channel, Dub Effects. But today we're gonna check out how to do live looping in Bitwig Studio. I actually did a video on live looping in Bitwig a few years back, but I get a lot of questions about live looping in Bitwig Studio, so here we go. So first off, we need to do a little bit of preparation before we get going with the live looping. So first out, I usually add a couple of tracks and add some instruments to these tracks and decide if I'm gonna record some live instruments on top. And for this track today, we have a little set here of instruments. First out, we have a guitar patch from Omnisphere. And we have some effects and whatnot to give it a little bit of space. Then on the second track, we have a brushed drum loop. On our third track, we have a bass, also from Omnisphere. Or from Trillion, but it's within the Omnisphere synth. Next track, some strings. Then we have another Omnisphere patch, droplets. We can obviously change this on the go when we create the track then. On the next track, it's just a simple filtered piano from Serum 2, the Baby Grand Piano 2. And I added this patch to get a little bit like a lo-fi piano kind of thing. Then we have a kick loop. Perks, percussion. Really filtered. To just get some mid-range, upper mid-range sizzle. And then we have a clip of claps. It goes hand in hand with a kick. Hi-hats. And then finally, an instance of contact with the piano. And finally, we have some audio input from this Osmo synth with a pad. Or a flute. As you can see, we have some clips here prepared with some loops. These audio loops, but we are going to layer and record clips of MIDI. Right, so next up, it's also important to go into the project panel in Bitwig. So we have this little like folder icon in the bottom right corner. And if you press settings there, you can actually change the default launch quantization, the behavior of how these different clips will launch when we trigger them. And we have a main and we have an alternative way of launch quantization, and it's set to 2 bars. Another important thing, if you're recording stuff into these clips on the go, is to set the post-recording action. And this is usually off, I think, but we need to set this as play recorded, so that after the clip has finished recording into this clip launcher, the clip will start to play. Right, so I think we're set up, so let's launch some hi-hats here and start layering instruments and do some live looping. And let me know in the comments if you have any questions or, yeah, if you want to get more of these kind of live looping videos. Yes, I'm not super happy with this round, but as you can see, it's quite easy to get going with live looping here in Bitwig Studio. Yeah, so if you have any type of comments or questions, let me know in the comment section. And as always, please subscribe if you're new to my channel and press the bell so you don't miss out on any of my upcoming videos. And by all means, let me know in the comments what kind of content and videos you'd like to see here on my channel. Have a nice weekend and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!